Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you all to ICICI Bank's results conference call with Mr. Sandeep Batra, Executive Director, ICICI Bank, and Mr. Anindya Banerjee, Group Chief Financial Officer, ICICI Bank. Mr. Batra will now give you an overview of the results, which will be followed by a Q&A session. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, and good evening, everyone, and thank you for all joining us on this Saturday afternoon. The Indian economy continues to remain resilient amidst international geopolitical tensions, with upward revision in GDP growth estimates for the first half of FY2025 by RBI, reflecting the consistent actions and initiatives of the policymakers. The underlying growth momentum is visible in several indicators such as expansion in manufacturing PI and a healthy tax collection. We continue to monitor the evolving global and Indian economic developments. At ICICI Bank, our strategic focus continues to be on growing our core operating profit less provisions, that is profits after tax excluding treasury through the 360 degrees customer-centric approach and by serving opportunities across ecosystems and micro markets. We continue to operate within our strategic framework to strengthen our franchise and expand our technology and digital offerings, maintaining high standards of governance, deepening coverage, and enhancing delivery capabilities are our focus areas for risk-calibrated, profitable growth. Our board has today approved the financial results for the quarter and year-end ended March 31, 2024. I would like to highlight some of the key numbers. First of all, on the profit and capital, the net interest income increased by 8.1% year-on-year to 19,050 crore rupees in Q4 2024. The net interest margin was 4.4% in Q4 2024 compared to 4.43% in Q3 2024 and 4.9% in Q4 2023. The net interest margin was 4.53% in FY2024. Fee income grew by 12.6% year on year to 5,436 crore rupees in Q4 2024. Provisions, excluding provision for tax, were 718 crore rupees in Q4 2024. The profit before tax, excluding treasury, grew by 19.2% year on year to 14,602 crore rupees in Q4 2024. The core operating profit grew by 10.5% year on year to 15,320 crore rupees in Q4 2024. The profit after tax grew by 17.4% year-on-year to 10,700 crore rupees in Q4 2024. The consolidated profit after tax grew by 18.5% year-on-year to 116.72 crore rupees. 11,672 crore rupees in Q4 2024. The standalone ROE was 18.5% in Q4 2024. The board has recommended a dividend of rupees 10 per share for FY2024. The declaration and payment of dividend is subject to requisite approvals. At March 31, 2024, the bank had a net worth of over 2.4 lakh crore rupees. After reckoning the impact of proposed dividend, the CET ratio was 5.6% and total capital adequacy ratio was 16.33%. Moving on to deposit growth. The total period-end deposits increased by 19.6% year-on-year to 14,12,825 crore rupees at March 31, 2024. Period-end term deposit increased by 27.7% year-on-year to 8,16,953 crore rupees at March 31, 2024. Average current account deposits increased by 13% year-on-year. Average savings account balance increased 4.6% year-on-year. The bank opened 152 branches in Q4 2024, 623 branches in the last 12 months, and has a network of 6,523 branches and 17,119 ATMs and cash recycling machines at March 31, 2024. The bank added about 12,000 employees in the last 12 months and had about 1,41,000 employees at March 31, 2024. Moving to loan growth, the domestic loan portfolio grew by 16.8% year-on-year and 3.2% sequentially at March 31, 2024. The retail loan portfolio grew by 19.4% year-on-year and 3.7% sequentially. Including non-fund outstanding, the retail loan portfolio was 46.8% of total portfolio. The bank calibrated its pace of growth in personal loans, and it grew by 35.5% year-on-year in the current quarter as compared to 37.43% in the previous quarter. The bank continued to work on increasing pricing, further refining parameters and optimizing sourcing costs, resulting in a lower disbursement of personal loans during quarter as compared to the previous quarter. The credit card portfolio grew by 35.6% year-on-year, 6.5% sequentially. The business banking portfolio grew by 29.3% year-on-year and 5.7% sequentially. The SME business comprising borrowers with a turnover of less than 250 crore rupees grew by 24.6% year-on-year and 3.8% sequentially. The rural portfolio grew by 17.2% year-on-year and 4.5% sequentially. Growth in domestic corporate portfolio was 10% year-on-year and flat sequentially at March 31, 2024. 67.7% of the total loan portfolio, excluding retail and rural, was rated A- minus and above at March 31, 2024. Moving to digital initiatives, we continue to enhance the use of technology in our operations to provide solutions to customers. iLens, the retail lending platform, is being updated on an ongoing basis, personal loans and education loans, now integrated in the platform along with mortgages. About 71% of the trade transactions were done digitally in FY2024. The volume of transaction done through trade online platforms grew by 29.2% year-on-year in FY2024. We have further simplified bank guarantee journeys with new enhancements. Smart BG Assist is a solution to enable digital execution of bank guarantees for creating and validating text, e-stamping, digital signatures, amongst others. Moving to asset quality. The net NPA ratio declined to 0.42% at March 31, 2024, from 0.44% at December 31, 2023, and 0.48% at March 31, 2023. During Q4 2024, there was a net addition in gross NPAs of 1,221. The gross NPA additions were ₹5,139 crore in Q4 2024 compared to ₹5,714 crore in Q3 2024. Recoveries and upgrades in NPAs, excluding write-offs and sale, were ₹3,918 crore in Q4 2024 compared to ₹5,351 crore in Q3 2024. The gross NPAs written off were ₹1,707 crore in Q4 2024. There was sale of NPAs of ₹327 crore for cash and security receipts in the current quarter. The provision coverage ratios on NPAs was 80.3% at March 31, 2024. The total fund base outstanding to all borrowers under resolutions as per various extent regulations declined to ₹3,059 crore or 0.3% of total advances at March 31, 2024 from ₹3,318 crore as at March 31, 2023. The bank holds provisions amounting to ₹975 crore against these borrowers, borrowers under resolution as of March 31, 2024. The loan and non-fund based outstanding to performing borrowers rated BB and below reduced to ₹5,528 crore at March 31, 2024 and ₹5,853 crore at December 31, 2023. The total provisions during Q4 2024 were ₹719 crore or about 4.7% of core operating profit and about 0.2% of average advances. The bank continues to hold contingency provisions of ₹13,100 crore at March 31, 2024. Going forward, we will continue to operate within a strategic framework while focusing on micro markets and ecosystems. The principle of fair to customer, fair to bank, and one bank, one team will guide our operation. We focus on building a culture where every employee in the bank serves customers with humility and upholds the value of brand ICICI. We aim to be a trusted financial service provider of choice for our customers and deliver sustainable returns to our shareholders. With this, I conclude my opening remarks. I'll be happy to take your question.
Thank you very much, sir. We will now begin the Q&A session with Mr. Batra and Mr. Banerjee. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Today's announcement is on the bank's financial performance. Hence, we would like to request you to ask questions related to that. Please write to the corporate communications team separately for any other queries. Due to time constraint, I request all of you to ask two questions at a time. If you have additional queries, you may join the queue again.
No, I just wanted to clarify. I think I just want to clarify that the bank's personal loan grew at 32.5% and not 35.5%, which I said.
Thank you very much. The first question is from the line of Shayan Ghosh from Mint. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, Shayan.
Hi. Hi. Two questions, sir. The first is, how confident are you of the resilience of your IT infra when it comes to regulatory scrutiny? That's the first one. The second is, have you received any particular feedback from the RBI in the past couple of years that the regulator has repeatedly, you know, expressed concerns about?
No, thank you, Shayan. I think IT resilience and customer security is of paramount importance to us. And this is not constrained by any budget. In fact, our IT and cybersecurity spends as a percentage of overall spends between 2019 has moved up from 5.6% to about 9.4% in the current fiscal year. Having said that, this is an ongoing effort, and there could be instances of outages and errors in any bank. We have an ability to take quick recovery and corrective actions, and we will remain focused on improving our capabilities in this area. As regarding discussions with the regulator, this is an ongoing discussion on every aspect which we have, and we remain focused on complying with the regulatory guidelines which RBI gives us from time to time.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. We'll take the next question from the line of Ankur Mishra from ED Now Swadesh. Please go ahead.
Good evening, gentlemen. I just wanted to draw your attention towards the margins front, which you have posted around 4.4%. What is the year look like? I know you don't give guidance generally, but I want to extend the part asking, how are you going to maintain your profit when you're saying, meaning it will be more on a volume front or you will go for protecting the margin?
Thank you, Sudesh. As you are aware, the net interest margin was 4.4% in this quarter compared to 4.43% in the previous quarter and 4.9% in Q4 of last year. In Q3, we had the benefit of about 4 bits on account of interest on income tax refund. So the full year NIM has been about 4.53%, and which compares very similar to what was there in FY23 at about 4.48%. As you are aware, our objective is to maximize overall profitability, which includes all levers. They include NIM, of course, as an important lever. There is expenses, there is fees, and there is, of course, provisions. As a business, what we really focus on is growth of risk-calibrated operating profit, which is, of course, core operating profit less provisions. We will continue to grow our liability franchise in healthy ways and optimize both the quantum and cost as a starting point, and then price our lending opportunities in an appropriate way. As we are aware, we have been talking about trying to deliver a 360 system from an overall customer point of view. We do expect NIM should be range bound, adjusted for seasonality, of course, until unless there is any change in repo ratio. As there are imponderables during the year, which we are not really aware of, as we have mentioned, repricing of term deposits will continue even in Q1 of 2025. Going ahead, we do expect RBI to undertake a shallow rate cut, and we will see how this goes along during the course of the year.
Okay. Also, in the year ahead, where do you think will be the levers of growth for your bank?
No, the levers continue to be the same. I mean, India is in a, has opportunities. As we have been saying, we will look at risk-calibrated growth. There is, of course, growth of the balance sheet, which is also a lever, which is largely driven by the economic activities. And you are, I mean, you know the economy as well as I do. For us, there are levers in terms of yields that we, interest rates that we charge to our customers, the cost of funds which we pay to our depositors, and there is a fee line that we have in terms of offering various services to our customers. And expenses, there are multiple levers of expenses which include, outsourcing costs, there are internal costs, and of course there is a line of provision. So there are six or seven levers which are there for a bank at all periods of time. And the levers could be different during the course of the year. It could also be different by various markets and product segments that we operate in. And our objective is to optimize the opportunities. And of course, needless to say, we will always operate within the guardrails of defined risk parameters.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Our next question is from the line of Falakna Sayed from Deccan Chronicle. Please go ahead.
Hi. This capital raising, you know, the certificate of deposits in the overseas market of 1.5 billion and NCDs at 25,000 crore, at what rate are you raising? And what will the proceeds be used for? And in, when will the when will the capital raising happen?
Hi, Falak. As you are aware, we take this enabling approval in the beginning of the year. Even last year, we had taken a similar kind of an approval. During the course of the year, I mean, we look at various opportunities. If the rates become favorable, then at various points of time, they can. We can look at raising. So at this point of time, there is not a definitive plan. This will play out during the course of the year, depending on our needs of funds and the rates that we are going to be getting from the market at that point of time. It could be both domestic and international. As you are aware, it's about 25,000 crores domestically and about $1.5 billion for international market.
And one clarification, I always thought that Lombard was a subsidiary of the bank. But this is saying that, you know, the release is saying that it has stopped becoming, ceased to be an associate and has become a subsidiary of the bank. So what is the plan of action there now?
No, Falak, I think when Lombard merged with ICICI with Bharti AXA about 4 years back, it ceased to be a subsidiary, held a little around 48% at that point of time. In the last quarter, we have increased our stake. Now it has become a subsidiary again. So that is what is the change.
Okay. And one of the lenders has seen, the RBI has asked them not to issue fresh credit cards. So how much of market share will you gain? How will that help your business?
No, I don't think so. It's fair to make any comments around that. We remain focused on our own business and we remain focused on our own IT resilience and cybersecurity. I'm sure they will be taking corrective actions and we wish them luck.
Okay. And branch expansion plans, what's the target for this year?
No, as we, as you are aware, we do have a micro market approach for opening branches. It comes bottoms up and then we make an assessment. During the course of the year, we opened about 623 branches.
Yes.
We do expect to open similar number of branches in FY25.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Hamsini Karthik from the Indo Business Line. Please go ahead.
Hi. So I have a request to make before I can ask my question. It would be really nice and helpful if you could please put out a presentation. It would help us understand your numbers more granularly before we can put out our questions, sir. Just one of the things that I'm picking up from the street is that some of the banks have cut down their lending on the personal loan front in the 10 to 15 lakh bracket. I would like to understand what is ICICI's experience and as a basket of unsecured personal loans, how are you seeing the health and quality of this evolve for the bank specifically?
We have been very happy with the quality of the portfolio of personal loans that we have been talking about. And I think we have explain this over a period of time. As you are aware, we continuously look at recalibrating our sourcing mixes at various periods of times, and clearly bureau scores is an important marker other than ticket size. At a lower end, we were anyway was a very, very small portion of our overall business. I think we keep on looking at the retail portfolio, recalibrating it, and whatever meets our overall threshold, we focus on that. But the short, but it is a fact that we have sort of recalibrated, as I talked about, the growth in our personal loans. During this quarter, it was down to about 32.5% against the previous quarter of about 37%. This is lying with what is happening in the market and our assessment of risk.
Okay. Where would the share of NBFCs to the corporate loans be in this quarter? And I would also like to understand the GNPA number of retail loans.
Sorry, NBFCs loan to retail?
On your wholesale book, sir. Share of NBFC loans in your wholesale book. How has that changed in the last 1 year?
It has come down. I'll just give you the number. Sorry, total outstanding to NBFC and HFCs was about 77,000 crores in March 24, and March 24 compared to about 78,000 in December 2023. The total, and this constituted about 6.5% of our total advances. So that is broadly the number. Last year, this number was about 70. Yeah, was about 82,000 crores.
Okay. And GNPA for retail portfolio, sir?
No, we don't give a segment to GNPAs. We are comfortable with the overall provisions which we have disclosed as part of our management.
Okay. And on the capital raising front, any particular reason why you prefer to dip into debt at this point in time over equity?
No, we have got a very healthy equity ratio. We have got no need for equity at all. Debt is an option which is available, and amongst the overall scheme of things, this is a small amount which we will use in case opportunities comes in terms of pricing.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Chinesh Parmar from Money Control. Please go ahead.
Hi. I hope. So my first question is, so in the last quarter, you had done some provisioning on your AIS investment. So in March, we got a message from RBI that was kind of looked at as an E for bank. So just wanted to get an understanding that have you done any write-backs from this provisioning? And also, are you keen on investing more in AIS?
No, I think the RBI guidelines did provide some relief. We made a provision for about 630 crores in the last quarter. Okay. Based on our current assessments, we have written back about 100 crores.
Okay, and anything on investing more in the AIF?
There is no current provisions. There is no current provision. Proposal on the table at this point of time.
Right. Second thing is on a few days back, you had a digital breach on your credit card, if I'm not wrong, concerning your app and specifically for credit card customers. So then you had said that if there is any monetary loss to customers, you would look into some compensation. So just wanted to get an understanding that has there been any request from customers, particularly on the compensation part, or have you provided any compensation?
No, there has been nothing material which has come at this point of time. I think we have already given a press release to the extent. The issue has been addressed, and even then we had reassured our customers that if there has been a misuse of that card, we will compensate them. We will see how this goes, but from our point of view, we have taken all the corrective actions that we needed to take.
Surely. Thanks.
Thank you. We take our next question from the line of Ashish Agase from PTI. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. I hope I'm audible.
Yes, Ashish.
Yes, sir. You mentioned about corporate loans being flat Q1Q. What sort of, generally Q4 is the most busiest of the quarters. So what led to that? And secondly, what's your outlook on that? And I'll come back with the second question.
Sir, I didn't quite get your question. I mean, you said corporate loans were
flat. Corporate loans were flat on quarter on quarter. Generally, Q4 is the busiest. So what led to it being flat?
No, I mean, this corporate loan also includes NBFC portfolio, and there were a few highly rated NBFCs which, PSU NBFCs which sort of repaid the loan. Barring that, we have grown this book year on year on 10%. So we will look at the overall portfolio. So in terms of the growth, in terms of the areas that we really want to be focused on, we are quite happy with the growth. As you are aware, we follow a 360-degree approach with the objective of catering to all banking needs. As far as CapEx is concerned, you're right. I mean, the government and PSUs are leading the CapEx cycle. And of course, we do expect to attract more private CapEx during the course of the year.
Okay, sir. And so secondly, why is the NII grown at a softer 8% in the current quarter, sir? Because they are both the compression in margin is not so large, or the loan growth is also quite substantial. But what would be the reason for that, sir?
No, the NIMs have come down, no? You see, sequentially, the NIMs are coming down.
No, a YOY basis, sir?
So on a YOY basis, if you look at it, in the fourth quarter last year, we had our peak net interest margin of 4.9%, which is at 4.4% this quarter. So that drop in margin has partly offset the, as you rightly said, the underlying growth in the assets.
Okay, sir. And you mentioned about 12,000 people being added during the fiscal year. But sir, from a sort of a qualitative perspective there, sir, what has been the impact of a player like Jio, known for its aggression, on the entire staffing side, sir?
Sorry, we didn't get the question. Asking about the impact of?
An aggressive player like Jio Financial, because generally there is this entire notion about ICICI Bank stuff being their favorite. That way, sir.
I think nothing specific to call out. We respect and look at what all, current and new competitors are doing and frame our strategies in line with what we believe we have to offer our customers. So that's about it. Nothing specific to call out.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Our next question is from the line of Richard Fargos from The Informist. Please go ahead.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Good. Your audio.
Yeah, hi,
sir. I'm sorry. We're unable to hear you now. Can you speak to the handset, please?
Yes. Hi, sir. This is Subhana Sheikh calling from Informist Media. So my question is regarding co-lending. So you just said, that you've been witnessing, slowdown in your unsecured and personal growth, and you want to, recalibrate that growth. So on co-lending, are there any concerns? Are you hesitant partner with other NBFCs?
No, we look at partners, and in case it makes sense, we do it. But at this point of time, this is a very, very small portion of our overall lending. I mean, for us, we look at customers from a 360 basis, and we would like to have the overall relationships. If anything fits within that, we do it. Otherwise, it's okay.
But are you hesitant in terms of, partnering with other NBFCs for that matter?
We do make an assessment. If it makes sense from an overall angle, we will look at it. But it has to make both commercial and it has to pass corporate filters. Wherever that does, we will do it.
And so, my another question is on slippages. If you could throw some light on slippages as to what were your numbers for the Jan-March quarter and what segment contributed towards your slippages?
You're talking of the quarter?
Yes, sir, the quarter.
For the quarter, we had a total slippage of about 5,139 crores. Retail and business banking constituted about 4,900 of it. Corporate and SME was 211. In terms of recoveries, the total recoveries were 3,918. And retail and business banking recoveries were most of it, which is 3,200 odd. And corporate and SME recoveries has been about 700 crores. So with a net addition of about 1,221 crores.
Okay. All right, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. We take the next question from Ritu Singh from CNBC TV. Please go ahead.
Hi, Mr. Bakker. Just wanted to follow up on that initial question on the IT infrastructure. Anything out of the ordinary in your conversations with RBI about the status of the resilience of the IT infrastructure? And if you expect for the bank's spend to go up further from 9.4% in FY24?
No, Ritu, discussions with the regulator are confidential, and we do have discussions with the regulator on every aspect of the business, which includes IT. In terms of the IT spend being 9.4% of 2024, as I mentioned, our resilience and customer security is paramount, and it is really not constrained by the amount of money. Whenever we need to spend money, that has never been a constraint. We will remain focused. Having said that, at this scale, you know, there can be odd outages which do happen and errors do happen at this scale. We would like to remain focused on ensuring quick recovery. And we will, this is an area which is always a work in progress, and we will continue to improve our capabilities in this area and with the evolving technology and environment as we go along.
Okay, and while you do not give any guidance, we just wanted a broad commentary on any specific segments where you're seeing a stronger credit demand or where you expect the growth engines of the bank this year. We, of course, within the parameters of your guardrails, the risk guardrails that you have in place.
No, Ritu, as you are aware, we keep on looking at opportunities both at the micro market level and even from an overall angle. And wherever we do find opportunities, meets the risk and reward framework, we are more than happy to lend. And we have been doing this consistently for many years, and the strategy will continues to remain. As India's GDP will continue to evolve, so will our overall strategy. So we are confident of India's growth, and in line with whatever growth that happens within the country, and if it falls within our risk framework, we are happy to lend.
Thank you. Ritu Singh, I'll request to come back for a follow-up question. Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ben from the New Indian Express. Please go ahead.
Hi, Sandeep. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
But you can speak louder.
Hi, Sandeep. Can you hear me?
Yes, that's better.
Okay. No, my question is about, you said that okay, your first slippage is almost 95% came from retail. Is it unsecured loan side or is it farm loan? What is that?
No, we don't give the breakup, but this is a combination of retail, rural, as well as business banking. So, but if you see the net slippages has been just about 1,221 crores, from our overall bill. So it's not really a very high number.
Okay.
I mean,
How good is your? There have been reports about delinquency level, spike in delinquency level in personal loans and credit cards. How good is the asset quality of these two verticals for you?
So as we have mentioned, I think we are quite comfortable with the quality of book that we have obtained, and the NPA numbers are well within our tolerance limits, and we continue to look at this book carefully, and wherever we have to recalibrate based on risk parameters, we do it on a regular basis.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. We take our next question from Preeti Singh from Bloomberg. Please go ahead.
Mr. Batra, I just wanted a clarification. I couldn't hear very well. So you said that your IT spend had increased from 5.6% in 2019 to 9.4% for this fiscal, for fiscal 2024. Is that correct?
That's right.
Okay. And you said also as part of your total spend, so I guess your total expense, right? Just clarifying the language here.
So that is part of our total spends, yes. Our total expenses, I mean, IT spends are becoming a larger part of it, and naturally so given the extent of digitization and technology that is being deployed in the overall system.
And
this is part of expense means OPEX, sir. I just want to clarify that.
Yeah, okay. And part of OPEX, you said, right? Okay. And I just had this one thing. You said, you know, broad outages can happen, but you basically ensure quick recovery. So I wanted to check, do you have like an internal benchmark which is different from the benchmark that RBI might set for these things?
So we keep on looking at our systems, and it depends on systems, et cetera. We do categorize it, and customer-facing systems, obviously the benchmarks are certainly tighter, and we monitor them 24/7 and keep on looking at how they are working. I mean, this is it happens during the normal course of business in any case. I mean, you would know if I have a problem as fast as I do. So it's,
yeah. Thank you. Okay.
So I'm as a customer. So.
Thank you. Next question is from Anshika Kayasta from Hindu Business Line. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Good evening.
Hello.
Hello.
Go ahead, ma'am. You're audible.
Yes. Sir, just a couple of other large banks have mentioned that given the pressure on deposit accretion that is being seen, we could see some amount of slowdown in the loan growth in the coming year. Just wanted to understand how are you seeing the loan and deposit dynamics sort of play out for you, and do you expect a moderation in some certain loan segments in the coming year?
Cool. You know, deposit growth for the banking system has increased about 12.9% year on year. You know, as far as we are concerned, during the last quarter, we grew at about 19.6% and 6% sequentially. The term deposits have grown by about 27% year on year and about 1.6% sequentially. Even the average deposit has been growing at a healthy rate of about 19.9%. We will see, you know, we are not going to be raising deposits at any cost. From our point, as a bank, we believe in, you know, trying to meet the entire banking needs of a customer. So it is not necessarily about a bank deposit or a car or a car. It's about essentially, you know, the overall money in bank. We remain focused on that. So as long as we are able to do a 360 degree approach and provide good service to our customers, we should be okay.
Do you expect the loan growth to sustain at this level going ahead?
No, it's very difficult to forecast what is going to happen in the future, and it don't really kind of forecast. For us, maintaining a good liquidity is important. As we reported, the average LCR for the quarter was about 123%.
Right.
We have been doing at a healthy rate. We will see how it pans out during the course of the year. I mean, it's very difficult to change. I mean, we for us, it's important to focus on the service. For us, it's important to ensure that we have the right set of values and systems and processes in place to serve our customers to the best of our ability. We will continue to remain that. And if we are able to look after the interests of the customers, I think deposits will grow in line with how the country has been growing.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you. Our next question is from Sachin Kumar from Financial Express. Please go ahead.
Yeah, my question has been asked.
Thank you, Sachin.
Thank you. Next question is from Mimansa Verma from NDTV Profit. Please go ahead.
Hi, good evening, sir. So my question is on the capital adequacy ratio. The year-on-year hit is about 201 basis points. Can you throw some light on that? Over the year, the capital hit is quite disruptive.
So there are a couple of things. One is, of course, you are aware there has been a growth during the course of the year. there has been from a year perspective, there was a reduction which went to RBI guidelines for personal loans, which is also some kind of an impact. And then we did acquire some shares in ICICI Lombard, which also has an impact. But having said that, our overall capital adequacy ratio remains healthy at
16%. Oh. I think that's from the
Did you get the answer?
I'm sorry, but you can speak through the handset, please. There's a lot of echo while you're speaking. It's coming muffled, sorry.
Can you repeat the answer? I didn't hear it properly.
No, I mentioned that we remain quite healthy in terms of capital adequacy ratio for the year. It is 16.33%, which is for March. The reduction that you're talking of between the last fiscal and the current fiscal year is on account of RBI regulations around NBFCs and personal loans, which they came into place, which had an impact, which we sort of reported in the last quarter. During this quarter, there is a small impact on account of our acquisition of shares in ICICI Lombard. Notwithstanding that, we have a pretty healthy capital adequacy ratio. So the 16.33 number as of March was about 18.34. So there has been a bit of a drop on the reasons that I really talked about, and of course there has been growth in balance sheet during the course of the year.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. This brings the conference call to an end. On behalf of ICICI Bank, we thank you all for joining us. You may now disconnect your lines. Thank you again.